31 for chest.
My name is Tyler Obermoller. I'm a wildlife biologist at the Mendelia Wildlife Research Station. Today we're GPS collaring newborn fawns. We're looking at survival, causes of mortality, movement, and also just some dispersal rates. And what that allows us to do is see how they're selecting different cover types by different seasons, you know, where they're moving at winter to get for winter cover, all different aspects. We use drones to find the fawns in the landscape. So we started that in 2019 to kind of hone in that method. We did that for 2 years, and then last year was our first official year of the study where we GPS collared 75 fawns to really monitor for causes of mortality, survival, and movement. And now, so this is in 2022 now, so this is our second year, and we have one more year after this. The overall goal is to get the GPS collar on the fawn. We want to take blood, we want to take body morphometrics, all those body measurements. So if we can take a bunch of those, we may see, you know, these smaller fawns may be more susceptible to predation. So that's why we want to take those. But we also want to take blood because we want to look at health factors. Or the overall goal is to have a fast capture time because we want to get that fawn collared, get all that stuff done, and then let that fawn go and get back reunited with its mother. So that's why we want to have a really fast capture time. We want to talk quietly, you know, wear gloves, do everything we can to reduce scent. The last time research has been done in this area has been 20 years ago. The landscape has changed, the density of coyotes has changed. So we really just want to get an updated parameter estimates of survival, look at causes of mortality, to really get a better idea what's happening here. And this can better inform the deer population model, which can then help us better inform those harvest regulations each year.